That's what a separation is, Cal. It's space between two people.
You and Lydia are my world.
Your husband.
They were separated.
Did you mention that he's some kind of environmental activist?
Lost! Magically in the Kafka-esque corridors.
You're not getting a dog.
This is really between me and Dad. You don't really get a say.
Is that a friend of yours?
In a manner of speaking, that's Claire.
I always assemble the stuff at home because Cal's too busy saving the world.
Well, luckily for you, I'm unencumbered by a social conscience.
Thank you.
You're Alan Keynes, you?
You're lost. If you imagine you are going to read of model children, you had better lay down the book immediately. Not one of the seven was really good, for the very excellent reason that Australian children never are.
Just between the two of us, neither am I.
In news just a hand, Nassim Zari, a young Syrian refugee, was abducted from a hospital ward where she was receiving medical treatment.
However well-meaning, this action is misguided. I would encourage anyone who knows anything about her whereabouts to please contact authorities.
Oh, Ms. Payne, I'm sorry. Ms. Newton doesn't work with us anymore. But if I could be of any assistance...
You can't just turn up, Mrs. Payne. If you want to see her, you need to talk to me first.
Relax, I'm not psycho. Just need Josephine Newton.
10th floor.
Josephine Newton here?
Do you have an appointment?
I don't need an appointment now. Ms. Newton stopped the council bulldozing my house. I'd be living in a car park if it wasn't for her.
Well, she does love a car park. Perhaps you could leave your name and number and I'll pass it on to...
I don't have time for that.
Finchley Financial Management versus Camden Commercial Loans, appealing the motion to remand an order of non-compliance with pooling and servicing agreements. Sounds fascinating, but...
Come on, play with me. I can't do something this tedious by myself.
Josephine!
Do I need to call security?
Josephine Newton! It's Martha Payne here! Where are you?
I'm going to...
Josephine! Josephine Newton!
Martha!
Lawyer, you're going to have to...
What's going on?
Plenty.
I work as a barrister now.
Good for you!
I'm sorry, I tried to explain...
Take a seat. So I can still speak for you in court, but you can't really hire me directly.
Why not?
Well, if you want to engage Josephine, you first need to take me on as your solicitor. I'll contact Josephine's clerk and then they contact Josephine.
I don't have time for all that nonsense. The strife I'm in is urgent.
Oh, if the council are trying to reopen your demolition order, we've not got all the paperwork.
It's bigger than the council. Last night I was arrested.
On what charge?
Well, a whole bloody list, but one of them was kidnapping.
I would encourage anyone who knows anything about her whereabouts to please contact authorities.
Staff at the hospital have echoed the minister's concern for the girl's welfare.
Miss Zari needs ongoing medical care. Her health is definitely at risk if she's not returned to hospital immediately.
Police
confirmed. Yes, the asylum seeker escaped. I do watch the news.
Take a closer look.
Miss Zari's disappearance. But police will not confirm whether any charges have been laid.
Wait.
We'll have more on this story as it comes to hand.
Well, who's this then?
This is Mr. Hughes, a colleague. I value his opinion.
We need to know what the federal police asked you.
Oh, kept me there half the night answering questions. Didn't even get a decent cup of tea. Hmm.
What questions?
Blah, blah. Did I know Nassim was in the laundry trolley?
Did you?
How can I be expected to know what's in the laundry? I'm a volunteer.
Then why did you move the trolley?
It was in the way. Some dillard left it right outside that girl's door.
But you know Nassim Zari.
Met her a couple of times, nice enough.
Do you know where Nassim is now?
Not a clue. Yep. I'd swear on any holy book you put in front of me.
But you might know someone else who knows where she is.
See, that's a question they didn't ask me. Oh, he's a charmer, this one. Bit of a look or two. Watch out.
So you're abandoning me and Finchley Financial Management.
Oh, it breaks my heart. I'm not sure I should take this on.
You've got immigration experience.
2457 visa appeals. This is a totally different ballgame. Martha's facing serious charges.
She pushed the kid down the corridor in the dirty laundry. It's hardly the great escape. Let them prove it.
What about Whitney? This is already all over the news.
He wants to raise the profile of Knox Chambers.
No, this is not the sort of profile he had in mind.
But wild horses won't stop you, right?
Not once I get going.
And Martha probably baked you pumpkin scones once a week.
No, she didn't. She knitted Lydia a beautiful mohair cardigan.
Go on, do what you gotta do. Leave Whitley to me.
Excuse me, Dr. Renfrew? You're the doctor who treated Nassim Zari.
I said everything I had to say in my statement. Why do you people assume that I had anything to do with this?
I'm not with the police.
No comment.
I'm not a journalist, I'm a barrister. I represent Martha Payne. She's with the Pink Brigade. One of the volunteers working here at the hospital.
I know who she is, and they've made it very clear to me that I can't discuss this with anyone.
Being a witness for the prosecution doesn't
really
prevent you from talking
to me. No comment, okay? Sorry.
I've checked, and the Commonwealth haven't called Dr. Renfrew as a witness in the case against Martha.
He could have a suspect personal history or got done for flirting with his patients.
No, they know he's sympathetic to Nassim and they don't want him in court.
You think someone read him the Border Force Act?
Well, why else would he be clamming up?
It would put me off. He could be sacked, thrown in jail if he says one word about Nassim's medical condition or the conditions of a detention.
Not if he skirted around the act.
You want to call him as a witness? What's your justification?
I need the doctor to prove that Nassim was able-bodied enough to climb into that trolley on her own.
Not to talk about why she might have wanted to escape the detention centre in the first place.
No, of course not.
Mm-hmm.
But if he goes off page, I can't prevent that.
You can't help yourself. All you have to do is get your old dear out of this. You don't have to take on the whole issue of offshore detention.
If a GP sees evidence of abuse, mm-hmm. they are legally mandated to report it. But if a doctor in a detention centre reports
it... I love watching you fire up. It's like being back at uni.
Is the man who never fired up about anything.
That is not true. I was extremely committed to the Chocolate Appreciation Society.
Sorry, I forgot about that.
Those debates were fierce. Swiss versus Belgian, 90% cacao over 70.
Is white chocolate even chocolate?
Always the philosopher.
But you know that they won't enforce the act. Why would they? Any half-decent defence counsel would flush out all the bad stuff that they don't want the public to know about. They'd never do it.
Tough day at the office. Cal. How are you, mate?
Hey. Helen said you were here.
What's up?
Oh, just a minor co-parenting issue.
Oh, I could mediate. One free drink with counselling thrown in.
Don't worry, she's fine. Well, as fine as Lydia gets.
What are you having?
Beer, thanks.
Same again.
Please, yeah.
You know, I still have trouble getting my head around you and Lewis as colleagues. I used to call him the dark side of the law.
Oh, well, he probably still is a bit shady. Tell me about Lydia.
Last night she had a friend sleep over. She asked if Ellie could stay and I agreed. And then this morning Ellie turns out to be...
A boy.
Alex, did we ever announce a policy on co-ed sleeping arrangements?
Okay.
Yeah. Whoa. Tell me you had the contraception chat, please.
Yes, I had the contraception chat.
God.
So what did you say?
Well, what could I say? Didn't make a scene. And it's the 21st century. What message are we sending? We don't want to say sex is bad, right?
No, of course not.
Right.
But... she's 15. How old was he?
Hard to say. He had one of those wispy mustaches.
A mustache?
And a man bun. Oh. Yeah. Why? What difference does that make?
Well, I mean, it makes a lot of difference. We don't know anything about him. And if he is more than 2 years older than her, consent is not a defense.
Defense? Why do you always jump to the worst possible conclusions about every single human transaction?
Do you want to have that debate now? Because these are the people I deal with.
I don't want to have any debate. I just want to sort it out.
Well, can you find out a bit more about it?
Okay, all right, leave it with me.
Josephine tells you she's about to take on the government. Nothing big, just a little issue of offshore detention.
Wow, it's right up my alley.
Morning, Jackie. I need a favour. Our photocopier's packed it in again. You mind if I make a few?
I hope you're staying away from that Martha Payne woman, Jonathan. You know, if you're involved in covering up a crime, say kidnapping, you could get in serious trouble with the law.
I haven't kidnapped anyone yet.
There are so many other ways you can help young people. Like this. Now that is the winner of our annual Knox Chambers Music Scholarship. I'm just about to tell him the good news.
Yeah, nice.
Is it? Makes me want to stick pins in my eyes.
Well, if you don't like his music, why give him the prize?
Oh, it's Mr. Whitley's award. I just do the grunt work and he gets all the glory. You won't even remember the kid's name this time next week.
So what's your thing, Jackie? Soul? Funk? Country? Reggae?
I wouldn't know. I don't know where to start. I can't even play a note.
But you know what you don't like. And that's impressive.
Ooh. So, big day at school today?
Yeah.
Are you gonna see Alex?
Alex doesn't go to my school.
Okay, what school does he go to?
He's an apprentice.
Right. Wow. That. How long's he been doing his apprenticeship? This is good talk.
What I don't understand is how this Nazan Zari woman was allowed to escape custody. She was in this country illegally, and now she's on the loose. That, to me, shows complete and utter contempt for the laws of the land.
Hey, whoa, I was listening to that.
You're just gonna get worked up.
Well, some things are worth getting worked up over. You know your mum's latest case is all about this.
So?
And I protested against offshore processing of asylum seekers I don't know how many times.
And nothing's changed. So what's the point?
What's the... Lydia, if you think the government is doing something wrong, you have to take a stand.
Yeah, but are you really gonna change anyone's mind? Well, you're not going to change this, guys, or the government's, not by protesting. They know you're going to oppose them, and they know you're on the opposite side, and they just don't care what you think. I'm sorry, but it's true. Remember that protest you did against the bankers?
When you were Wayne?
You saw that?
Mum showed me the video. She said that was the day she fell for you. They looked totally sucked in.
Yeah, they were. Until I said the rich should just eat the poor. Whoa! The looks on their faces.
You'd find that.
She had no legal right to be in this country in the first place. So let's hope this Martha Payne woman has the common sense to put her on a boat straight back to where she came from.
5 minutes of your time. That's all I'm asking. I understand your situation and your reticence, but you treated Nassim. You know her. I'm sure you want to help.
I gambling away my career.
But what if we can work around the act so you don't get into any trouble?
Is that a guarantee?
I can't give you that. But couldn't you at least tell me more about Nassim?
It should never have happened. She cut herself climbing a fence at the center.
Was she trying to escape?
I tried to treat her wounds, but I must have missed something. One of her cuts became infected and she developed septicemia. She never told anyone about the fever until she went into septic shock and I had to fly her out. I wish I'd picked up on it earlier, but I can never fix the real problem. For any of them.
Jackie.
What's this about?
Sit down. Go on. You ready? Not classical.
What is that?
It's my cousin. She's 15 from the Democratic Republic of Congo.
Except it's not that democratic, right?
Right.
And it's her dream to be a famous musician. But first,
she's got to finish school.
What do you reckon?
I like it. Yeah, I really like it.
Yeah, you do, Jackie.
I do. I really like it. Yeah. And I can't wait for Mr. Whitley to find out that his music scholarship has gone to a teenage rapper from the Congo.
You people are part of this whole mess, as far as I can see. Why don't you do some homework and, you know, find out a bit more about Nassim? Maybe you'd find out she's not so different from you. No,
thank
she's
you.
Nicer than the lot of you put together.
Miss Hankins is anything. Not making any official statement to the press.
Where is she now? You tell us give us a clue, Martha.
What was that?
Well, they asked me what I thought.
Well, maybe it's a good idea to keep your thoughts to yourself. Maybe just for the time being.
That'll be the day.
The matters before us are the charges of perverting the course of justice, obstructing a Commonwealth officer in the execution of their duties, and kidnapping. Miss Newton, can you please ask your client to refrain from rolling her eyes?
Sorry, straight eyelash.
And to refrain from speaking.
Of course, Your Honor.
All right. How do you plead?
Can I talk now that...
Not guilty, Your Honor.
You need to sit down.
Dr. Renfrey, I understand you're designated as an entrusted person under the Border Protection Act. Is that so?
Yes, that's right.
And as such, you're prohibited from disclosing the reasons for your medical treatment of Nassim Zari.
Your Honour, can I ask why anything to do with the doctor's contractual obligations is relevant to the matter?
I was about to ask that very question. I'm not overly fond of the circus, Miss Newton.
Sorry, Your Honour.
So I will not appreciate these proceedings degenerating into a tightrope act.
I can assure you they won't.
then perhaps you'd do me the courtesy of clarifying why you have called Dr. Renfrey.
The purpose is twofold, Your Honour. To establish the timeline on the day Nazim Zari went missing.
Was abducted, Your Honour.
Can we call it what it was?
If I could complete my answer, Your Honour.
Continue, Miss Newton.
And Dr. Renfrew's evidence will also establish that Nazim Zari's physical condition enabled her to climb into the laundry trolley on her own.
Then I can assume that evidence will not traverse broader matters, which are not the subject of these proceedings.
Dr. Renfrew, when you last saw Nazim Zari, what was her physical condition?
She was weak, but she was still able to move around without any assistance.
When was that?
Last Wednesday, around 3:30, according to my notes. I was there to administer a new drip of antibiotics.
Wouldn't a nurse normally do that?
Yes, but I was concerned about her state of mind.
Objection, Your Honour. That is an opinion about mental health, and Dr. Renfrey is a physician, not a psychiatrist.
Warning, Miss Newton. I can hear that circus music.
Your Honour, Nazim Zari's state of mind on that day is relevant to the issue of free will.
Your doctor has established the timeline and the fact that Miss Zari was ambulant. Move on.
That judge knows exactly what I wanted to say.
He is not letting us go there.
You said they wouldn't charge me on the act, right?
Oh, I said it was highly unlikely. It's not a good look to charge a little old lady. I doubt they'd want to make it worse by locking up a hard-working doctor.
What if I made a statement to the press?
Well, strictly speaking, you can't, because the case is still ongoing, but...
And I found I couldn't stand back doing nothing for any longer, which is why I felt compelled to speak out about conditions at the offshore detention centre. Nazim has been under my care for some time. Her father, sadly, was lost at sea.
How safe are we really? She was in this country illegally, and now she's on the loose. Things like this just shouldn't happen. Where was security? Where are our so-called intelligence people? Who knows what this young woman's up to on the loose out there? That's the whole point of having offshore detention.
Mister...
What does a girl like that have to offer this great...
A car.
We were expecting the minister.
The office didn't call.
We called to confirm.
The minister's tied up in a briefing.
Oh, come on in.
Joining me is Wayne Carr, spokesman for the minister. Thanks for coming in.
It's good to be here, Max.
One of your doctors appears to have gone rogue.
It does appear that way, yes.
What's your department going to do about it?
Sorry, Max. Do?
Well, you're not going to let this doctor get away with it, eh?
Well, no, certainly not.
Well, then what are you going to do?
Well, we are definitely prosecuting under the Act.
Well, about time, too.
But we're not convinced that's enough of a deterrent.
Well, you're going to make an example of him?
Well, if we don't take a hard line, others could follow his lead.
Couldn't agree more.
Can't have our people breaking ranks, showing complete and utter contempt for the laws of the land and sympathy for desperate refugees who have risked their lives fleeing war-torn countries in leaky boats.
Yeah,
so we've been looking into more traditional methods of silencing dissent, drawing and quartering, stoning, waterboarding, super
yeah,
popular.
You can stop right
we've settled on crucifixion, Max.
Okay, mate, joke's over. Okay. Get out.
What the hell was that?
Okay.
Security.
Who is this dickhead?
Deep breath,
calm down. What are you
down.
Doing, mate?
Whoa.
Meldrum was on my case right from the start. I was hamstrung.
What did you expect? Free reign?
Mr. Whitley would like to see you both.
You did talk to him about this.
Haven't had a chance.
Oh, that button.
Which is why I felt compelled to speak out about conditions at the offshore detention centre.
Nazim Zari's whereabouts is still unknown. The case is expected to last for several days.
Whose brilliant idea was this?
We'll have more on this story in our...
Mine.
Well, you've lobbed a grenade.
G.I. Josephine, that's me. I realised that I should have spoken to you about this earlier.
You better fasten your seatbelts. I've just heard from an old mate of mine within the ministry. The charges have been laid against your doctor for speaking out.
You're kidding.
I didn't think they'd go that far.
You're all over the news.
I have not said a word to the media, and I specifically haven't mentioned these chambers.
Well, they found out somehow. It's fantastic. Apparently, a junior civil servant got the wrong idea from a radio report and pressed the panic button.
Well, that'll be a short career.
Well, there's no going back now. They've initiated charges.
So, just to be clear, you're okay with this?
Couldn't be better for Knox.
Okay.
We're fighting for civil liberties, freedom of speech. If we were any more virtuous, we'd be annoying.
Excuse me. Helena, we need to find Dr. Renfrey. What? Callum's downstairs.
Make it go backwards.
What happened? You didn't take on the man bun.
Oh, no, nothing to do with Lydia.
Oh, she put a stake on that.
Steaks don't work, you need ice.
Who says steaks don't work?
People who know what they're talking about.
Vegetarians.
Cheers.
No worries.
Nothing's broken.
Max Lawrence punched me in the face.
The radio job?
Yeah. And now he's charging me with assault, which is ridiculous. It's the other way around. I never laid a hand on him.
What were you doing at the radio station?
I was there in my departmental capacity. Remember Wayne Carr?
Oh, no. Where did you get the suit?
It was in the garage wardrobe.
Oh, is that this suit?
Sure is. Real fits, baby.
You enjoying this?
Well, just a little bit. Believe it or not, I was actually trying to help.
Wow.
When something is this wrong, somebody has to do something, right?
Yeah, like get themselves arrested.
Wow.
Everything okay? What are you wearing? Wedding or funeral? Ouch.
Yeah, I think I might need some lawyering.
I have my hands full.
Yeah, me too. Unless, of course, I sacrifice the world of high finance to help out an old buddy.
The charge is assault.
Who did you allegedly assault?
Max Lawrence.
Good work. And did you assault him?
No.
Oh, that's a pity.
I'm serious, Zareb. If you keep helping Mr. Whitley, he will never learn. Next time, you tell him to change his own batteries.
I'll let you know when the police brief comes through.
Thanks, mate. I owe you one.
Impersonate a barrister next time, and I will handball you a case or two.
Good night.
Craig, just the man I need to see. Hey, I'm in a corner with a big case that I need to flick. I wouldn't normally do this, but I am jammed. Any chance of you taking it on?
Well, I'll have to check with my clerk.
Naturally, but I need someone reliable. This is not just any old client. It's a major deal.
How major?
Big end of town. Finchley Financial Management versus Camden Commercial Loans.
Right. Sounds intriguing.
You have no idea.
What can you freeze lasagna for? I know, maybe we'll just get takeaway. Just keep it casual instead of a family meeting. She'll be less defensive if she thinks I just bumped into you and we're just gonna have dinner.
Well, I don't think we need to get sneaky.
She's a teenager. Sneaky is exactly what we need.
Right, yep, casual chat.
Yep, about. Why is this hard? This shouldn't be hard. We just need to lay down some ground rules.
Well, here's some rules. How about she waits until she's in her 30s before she has sex? This is way too complicated.
And whatever the rules are, they have to be consistent across both houses. You don't get to be the cool dad.
Fair enough.
Okay. Well, no sleepovers on weeknights.
Sounds reasonable.
We need to write these down. Mm. Lydia, what if this was an emergency? What if I had to go to hospital? Not that I do, but just call me now. I just hate her when she does this.
You think she's all right?
Yeah, she just doesn't always pick up. Mm. Oh, here we go. Oh, I might not make dinner. Phone's dying. No. Call me now.
Put an exclamation mark.
It's all in caps.
Ugh, it's her.
Ooh. What did she say?
She says, can I stay at yours tonight?
Oh, she is not getting away with this.
What do I say?
Just tell her you're not home.
Well, that is true. Not lying.
Call
me.
Hang on. She says, I've got my key, can I still stay? Well, no, of course. No, no. N-O, all caps.
Mm-hmm. Put an exclamation mark.
What if she really ran out of battery?
She'll be fine. At least until she gets home.
There must be someone we can ring.
She'll text. Just give her another half an hour. I've got a prep for tomorrow.
Ooh. Yeah, go for it. I'll stay anyway. Oh, I just want to see her, make sure she's okay. We'll do the whole family meeting some other time.
Sure.
You won't even know I'm here.
Lydia, answer your phone. I can't come and pick you up. She says she's at a friend's house.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, no, validated. Sue's home. She says she'll drop both the girls at school tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, who's Sue?
Tali's mum.
She's a bright, good-natured girl.
This will be good for you, won't it? Big high-profile case.
Yeah.
So what's up then?
What if I'm not as brilliant as I think I am?
Hmm.
What if our doctor loses his career or goes to jail?
Yeah, you can't think about that.
Well, I don't know. I tell myself that I'm doing this to help people, and I'm not sure I'm doing it for the right reasons.
Of course you are. So I think I know you better than anyone, and you're the... Yeah, you're okay. You know how I know? Only the good people have moments of doubt. All the assholes couldn't care less.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm only just okay.
You know, have your moments.
Is this a good idea?
Probably not. Sorry.
Nah, what the hell?
Not without my laptop. I had to tram it back from Tali's, but they're doing roadworks, so it all took ages.
Well, have a good day.
That's it. You're not gonna give me a hard time about my phone dying.
I'm gonna prepare a lecture for tonight. Where's your laptop?
Oh. I see. Someone's had a little slumber party. It was only a matter of time. Your boss, Mr. Smooth.
No, and he's not my boss. No, there's nothing. Can you just go to school and we'll talk about this?
Hey. Who wants pancakes?
Morning.
Morning.
Good night.
Didn't get a lot of sleep.
Oh.
Waiting up for Lydia. How's Callum's case going? You got a game plan?
Well, I called the station last night to talk to Max's producer. Found out he'd fired her.
Oh,
All-round nice guy.
No. It could work for us. But we're a woman scorned.
I love how you make the best out of the worst aspects of human nature.
Thank you.
What do you mean Nazim isn't well?
I thought you didn't know where she was.
Well, I heard a rumour, that's all.
Who from?
Oh, a little birdie told me.
What's wrong with her?
I don't want her in any more strife. That poor young thing's had enough. I mean, she's never done anything to anyone. I can't send her back.
This is very serious, Mrs. Payne. What if she needs medical treatment? We need to let Josephine know.
Well, I've already sent her a text thingy.
Martha?
Oh.
What's wrong with her?
She's got a fever.
Where is she?
I don't know.
Now is not the time to be coy.
That's not how it works. It's a phone tree. I phone someone, they phone someone else. And all of us only have one number.
We need to call that number now.
Right. How do you still find batteries for that thing?
Oh, don't be a smart fart. Just help me up. I'll need some privacy.
Cupboard of silence?
Yes.
If you'd like to follow me to the cleaning cupboard, Mrs. Payne.
See, manners, Jonathan. You could learn a lot from this young lady.
Come on.
What about court?
Well, I'll just have to stall. Can you think of a tactic? Documentation missing? Something? Anything?
I'm on it.
Johnny, we're going to need some transport. Urgently.
How urgently?
Just make sure it's legal.
Sorting out the bail. Can you sort out my career as well?
Have they sacked you?
Suspended while I'm facing charges.
We'll do everything we can for you, I promise. But right now, we need your help. You would have got something more inconspicuous.
Only favour I could call on at short notice.
My dad always said if you want to hide something, put it in plain sight.
Genius.
Kingswood 69, how bizarre. How bizarre, how bizarre.
I ring Vula, Vula rings Faye like links in a chain.
Is it a long chain, Martha?
Well, you'll see.
Pull in for some gas, a freshly pasted poster is a smile from the pack. Elephants and acrobats, lions next, monkey. Pele speaks righteous.
Normally, I have to tell my scruffier clients to spruce themselves up, but you have ticked that box. Is it the same shirt you were wearing yesterday?
Oh, yeah, I didn't make it home last night.
Notice I'm not asking any questions. We are civilized men, after all.
No, I just crashed with a friend.
A friend?
Yeah, I didn't get a lot of sleep, that's all.
Okay, shall we?
This is a simple matter, Your Honour.
That's for me to decide.
Indeed it is, ultimately. And I'd have to challenge the prosecutor's assumption and say this matter is anything but simple.
The defendant deceptively gained access to the radio station, and when he was ejected from the control room, he assaulted the victim, Mr. Lawrence.
I don't see deception charges anywhere on the charge sheet, Your Honour. I'd have thought a barrister of Miss Meikle's obvious experience would be more circumspect before bandying about such accusations.
Do you think you're bandying, Miss Meek?
No, Your Honour. It's assault. Plain and simple.
And I look forward to defeating that charge, Your Honour.
And I look forward to hearing you try, Mr. Hughes.
People jump and jive, and the clowns inch back around. TV news and cameras. There's choppers in the sky. Border patrol reporters ask the wherefore and why. Pella yells, we're out of here. Cena says, right on. Make your moves, start a grooves before they know we're gone.
Thanks, Faye. How you doing?
Jump into the Kingswood, headed for big lights. Wanna know the rest? Hey, by the rights, how bizarre.
This is like James Bond. Only with old ladies.
Well, who was James Bond answerable to, Sonny Jim?
That woman.
Mm-hmm. You can call me him. How many pink ladies are there? Oh, never enough.
Mr. Lawrence, you claim Mr. Docker assaulted you.
He did.
Why was Mr. Docker in your radio studio?
He misrepresented himself in order to perpetrate a hoax.
And he'd succeeded, hadn't he?
No. I realised he was a fraud.
Well, at the end. Do you usually vet your guests?
My producer does, yes.
So it was someone else's fault that this one got past the keeper?
It's not mine.
Were any phone calls made, any attempt to validate the identity of your guest?
Not by me. My producer was in the process of double-checking his bona fides when the doctor story hit the news.
And you wanted to get out ahead of the news cycle, get a quick comment from the department?
My producer made an error of judgment.
What name did Mr. Docker give?
He lied about who he was.
Sorry, I didn't quite catch the name that he gave you, and this was on air, so please don't shunt this one to your producer.
Wayne Carr.
Could you say that name again, please, and just a little quicker this time?
Wanker.
Wanker. Is this the business card that Mr. Docker presented?
Yeah.
Let's just take a closer look. On the crest, are they cigars the emu and kangaroo are smoking?
I wouldn't know.
Your Honour.
My apologies.
Keep your argument on the tracks, please, Mr. Hughes.
Just approaching the station now, Your Honour. It's obviously not a genuine business card, just as Wayne Carr is clearly a made-up name.
Which my producer should have realised. That's her job.
No further questions.
Thank you, Mr. Lawrence. All right. Roll out your one and only witness, Mr. Hughes, and this had better be good.
Look, we'll do our best, Your Honour. I'd like to call Miss Avery Wallypi.
You can't believe her. I sacked her. She's a moron.
That's enough, Mr. Lawrence. We're not on the radio now.
Your Honour, I should...
You'll get your chance, Miss Meikle.
There are cameras in the radio station, aren't there, to broadcast to the website and so on.
That's right.
But the cameras weren't operating on this particular occasion?
No, because Max asked me to switch them off.
The switch in the control room merely turns off the feed, doesn't it? Doesn't turn off the cameras as such. Nobody told the police this, did they?
No.
You have access to the footage of this alleged assault, don't you?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Running, drawing and quartering. Waterboarding is very popular.
Yeah, you can stop right
there. Settle on crucifixion, Max.
Okay, mate. Joke's over.
Okay. What the hell was that?
Well, that's just, you know...
Who is this dickhead?
The security? Hey,
whoa. What are you doing, mate? You're a dickhead. Oh!
Oh!
My learned friend would have us believe that my client assaulted Mr. Lawrence. My submission is there's no proof of that, and even if Mr. Docker did assault Mr. Lawrence, he was clearly acting in self-defense.
That was brilliant. Forgot to mention you're quite good at this lawyer stuff.
You know, sometimes, despite years of rigorous training in the complexities of the law, it all just boils down to a little razzle-dazzle.
Oh, no, not for me. Thanks, I still have to see. You go ahead, have one for me.
You're seeing your friend again tonight.
I thought we were civilized men.
We are civilized, curious men. So feel free to spill your guts.
You may be able to have that scotch.
So it's not just a one-night thing.
Well, let's just say I'm hopeful. I spent the night with my ex.
To hope, then.
Righty-o, folks, we're closing in.
Reading the book you brought into the hospital?
This is my friend, Josephine. She's a lawyer.
I'm very pleased to meet you.
Oh, seven little Australians.
I tried to read it, but there are words I still don't understand.
Oh, it's probably just for the best, love. I mean, sometimes breaking the rules will get you into a whole lot of hot water.
She needs vancomycin. If I can get some, I can treat her here.
Only until we negotiate some sort of solution, then we have to get her back.
They don't want to prosecute this. Cut a deal and get the charges dropped.
What will that achieve? The whole debate ends up gagged again.
You get Martha out of trouble, probably the doctor as well. It's not good enough. Miss Newton's client is in no position to bargain, Mr. Whitley.
With respect, Minister, Miss Newton's client has no need to bargain. The only evidence the police have against Miss Payne is the CCTV of her pushing a laundry trolley along a hospital corridor.
Wait outside, please.
If I could have a private word with Miss Newton.
All right, let's hear it.
You don't want to demonize an elderly citizen. Especially one who has sacrificed years of her life as a hospital volunteer.
All we want is the girl back.
Exactly. And prosecuting a doctor who has done nothing more than care for his patient's well-being isn't going to get you any closer.
Do you know where Nassim Zari is?
I know that if she doesn't come back, the government is going to look uncaring or irresponsible.
I'm listening.
We both know that you have discretion to remove charges when there is no likelihood of securing a conviction and it's not in the public interest.
What are you asking for?
We're as relieved as Nassim's doctor that she's been found safe and well. Let's just focus on that.
Will she be allowed to stay in Australia?
Our only concern at the moment is Nassim's welfare. She'll stay at the hospital until she's returned to full health and then we'll reassess her visa application.
What about you, Dr. Renfrey? The charges against yourself and Martha Payne have been dropped.
Yes, that's right. And we're very pleased with the result.
So I will personally be accompanying Dr. Renfrey back to the detention centre next week so I can see the conditions for myself. Thank you. Thanks.
Well, that's something to celebrate, isn't it? Shall we? But?
But I might have to take a rain check on the celebrations.
Okay, what about tomorrow then?
Good idea.
Oh, well, I'm overdue for a quiet night with Lydia. See you in the morning. Hello.
Hi.
How's Martha going?
She's very happy to be off the hook on kidnapping and ready for her next crusade.
What's that?
Unfair dismissal. The hospital asked her to hand in her tunic.
She's a volunteer.
She claims that the hospital paid for her bus fare and the other pink ladies have all gone out on strike.
Oh, I want a retirement plan just like Martha's.
Retirement? You?
Yeah, okay. Don't hold your breath.
You just don't know when to stop.
Why would I stop? I'm just getting started. Night.
No night.
Ah, how's our Knox Music Scholarship going? Posted the letter of congratulations yet?
Yes, it's posted.
Might take a little while to get there, though. I forgot to post it express. Did your dad talk to you about sleepovers?
He tried.
We don't want to ruin your life. We just... It's part of our job description. To worry about
don't.
You.
The whole thing with Alex was a mistake.
Well, even so...
It won't happen again.
But when it does with someone else, we need to lay down some ground rules.
Do we have to talk about this?
At some point, we should.
Is Dad coming over tonight?
No.
What about the other night?
Do we have to talk about this?
You're going to have to face it at some point, young lady.
Maybe that was a mistake too.
Heard Craig's news? Finchley's offered him all their legals, nationally.
Well, that's his drought broken, then.
Yeah, he'll be even more insufferable now. Hey, what are you doing tonight?
Nothing.
Do you want to do nothing together?
Sure. Fumbles the clerk going.
Didn't fumble so much today.
This man is the same man who has previously appeared before me accused of burning down your former office.
How can you want to help that nutcase? He tried to kill us.
You called me a big fat liar and a hopeless lawyer.
You shouldn't have said those things. You're not fat.
That's a really lovely dress. It's one of my favourite colours, red.
I thought you wanted me to run this case.
Yeah, I do.
Please aren't buying your story, Harry. Your dad's really worried about you, mate.
Harry!
Shut up, Harry!
Happy days! Well done.
The other night was nice, Cal, really nice, but I should have put you in a cab.
Why?
Because now it's messy.
Bad time.
Sex and takeaway.